There are many awesome cosmetics that you can find in Ghost of Tsushima, and combining them with armor and using the dice shop in the world will let you create some awesome combinations for sure. And in this video I want to highlight some awesome outfits that Dennis and I came up with, and we'll tell you how you can get these cool cosmetics if you don't have them yet, and then I also have a question for you at the end of the video. So a like would be super appreciated. And let's go. Let's start with my patchwork clan armor. Yes, I'm giving them cool names as well based on the different pieces. So we got the red Sakai clan armor that you get from my main mission in Act 2. And the red color is purchasable from a merchant. Then I'm rocking that red ghost mask that fits very well. I made a whole video about all the ghost armor skins that I will link to at the end of this one. And then to finish it off, I got the patchwork straw hat that you can actually easily buy at a merchant in Act 1, so as easy as that. You could also use the Oni Blade straw hat in my opinion, or use it in combination with other armor because it looks really cool. And this one is obtainable in the world close to the Kuta farmstead in the region of Act 1. So totally go and explore this area and then we'll see the red hat at some point and can grab it. And then go for the full red Blade Clan armor combination if that is what you like. Let's get a little funkier with the Monkey Traveler. Yes, it has the Traveler's attire, the final upgrade, and also a cool round hat, but this time one you get for upgrading the Kensei armor, and I discussed this armor before in my all armor video. So if you don't have it yet, I will leave a link to it in the pinned comment where you can also see my other Ghost of Tsushima content. I really love that armor, and I also got two cool combos with the chest piece coming up a little later in the video, but let's now go back to the Monkey Traveler, because the item that steals the show in this particular combination is the Sacred Mountain Messenger Mask, aka the Monkey Mask. And you get this one for completing all the Bamboo Strike challenges in the game, so good luck with that. It's a pretty unique activity. It was also the most challenging and sometimes annoying activity in the game in my opinion. But again, if you got them all, then you got the Ton of Resolve and also this cool mask. And I will link to a video with all the Bamboo Strike locations in the game in the video description. And there are more of these masks that I want to touch on in a second. But first, let's talk about the Blue Samurai. I showed my red variant. Now this is a blue one with the Gosaku armor, and you can get the blue dye for this at a merchant in Act 2 or up. We got the Samurai Clan 2 helmet, so you unlock that one after upgrading the Samurai Clan armor that you get early in the game. And this mask is an interesting one. You namely find this Serious Glare in the region of Act 3 over here on the map at the Zago Mill by running over the bridge and then entering the building on your right hand side. It will be hanging there under the lamp, so get it and then add it to this armor to make it really, really cool. The mask that I use for the next outfit is not that hard to get, but still very, very cool. And you get it from a gift altar early on in the game. So do some side content, go to a gift altar, and then you will find it. And it fits really well in combination with the rest of this armor. I call it the Sakai Thief Armor. And you see almost nothing of Jin's face, especially in the menu. I'm rocking the helm of the Clan Sakai armor set that you get for upgrading it to rank 3. And then we got the awesome Kensei armor that I tell you how to get again in that all armor video. And I'm using the special Dark Promise dye that you can get from the Black Dye Fender over here on the map. And I overall really dig this look, but I gotta say the variant that Dennis made, the Blind Wolf, it's really, really cool too. So the same Kensei armor, but a white variant. And you get that at the special white dye vendor that you find over here on the map. I already noted this in the Ghost video recently as well. And we use the coolest headband in the game called Blindfold. And that's of course also where the Blind Wolf name is coming from. And you find that one over here on the map in Act 2. It has you climb this tower, and then on top of the tower you find the Blindfold headband. Again, normally I'm not really into the headbands, but this one is really awesome. But the wolf mask is of course also very important for this look. And as you might expect, you get this one from completing all the fox dens in the game. And I will also link to a video with all the locations of those in the description. But what is also the case is that the moment you liberate the whole island, you see your progress by like zooming out completely. So if you cleared all of that, then you get some trophies, and then also all the question marks on the map will show up, so you can more easily find everything in the world. But I can see why you would want to focus on the Fox Dance first to already get the Wolf Mask. A mask that is easier to get if you already reached Act 3 is called the Ivory of Woe Mask, and I hope I pronounced that right. It goes over your mouth and you can find it again in that snowy Act 3 area over here on the map near the Kubara Crossing. And then just walk over to this house and you will find it here. And I just really like stuff like this. Like, it rewards exploration in an awesome way with a unique cosmetic. I prefer masks that go over the entire face, but I gotta say this one is a cool one to get. There's also a cool mask that you get after finishing the game. If you then go to the gift altar, you get Kijin's Blood. It looks really cool, but it's sadly broken. So I really hope there will be a way to maybe fix that in future content. Overall, I really hope they have DLC or sort of patches planned. We got no info on that yet, but when we know more, I will of course report it here on the channel. And we also got the Shattered Mask of Tomoe, and again, I hope I pronounced these names right, that look awesome, and this also has a ton of potential, but as the name suggests, it is also shattered. You get this one after completing all the Ishikawa Tales, so just follow them, you will see them easily on the map. And then at the end, you get the pretty cool mask. And we actually got a pretty cool outfit combination with that one. The white fox with the white ghost armor. Again, I will link to a video with all the ghost armor at the end of this one, for if you haven't seen it yet. Because not everyone can sadly get the white ghost armor. You cannot miss the hat. Everyone gets it from a main story mission at the end of Act 1. Okay, let's get weird now. Say hello to the naked madman. And we also discussed this armor already in the all outfits video. It's likely the final armor you get in this game, because you unlock it after completing all the hot springs. Also, a link to all the locations in the video description. And then you just need the Tengai hat to finish off the wacky combination. And you find that one in the Act 3 region near the Yokagu Temple. From there, it's like near the lake. And there will also be actually a yellow bird guiding you to that location as well. True mastery begins where individual ego ends. Especially in your underwear. Okay, let's go back to a more badass look, although you could argue the naked madman looked pretty dope. Skeletal Vengeance, as the name suggests, it gives you more of an undead vibe. Really, really dig it. You get this mask in Act 3 near Izumi Village. Place your pin on the map here, then grab your horse, and we actually have to climb up a mountain now. And then in the end, you'll reach this lumber mill, where on the table, you will find this mask. Think it actually looks pretty cool in combination with the blue samurai look. If you are not in Act 3 yet, then you can already get the Wood Spirit Straw Hat. That looks pretty nice. I find it cool how just all these hats cover your eyes. Although the monkey mask is already doing that in this menu example. So you get this one in the Act 2 region. When you are about to enter this area for the first time, it's close to the Marsh Rock Shrine. And I think we actually saw this statue in one of the pre-release footage. It might have been the State of Play that was already hinting at cool cosmetics that you could get in the open world. So totally go here in the middle of the river and then grab the awesome hat. And I'm curious, like, what is your favorite outfit combination that I showed you here in this video? Totally let me know in the comments down below. But I actually want to ask you something as well. You likely made some awesome pictures of the game, likely with your outfit that you like to wear as well. So I want to see them, and I want to highlight the best ones at the end of my future Ghost of Tsushima videos. It's kind of something cool I like to do. I also did it with Jedi Fallen Order and some other games as well. So if you made some cool pictures or got a cool outfit combination, then totally email them to input@joeraptor.com, or you can also reach out to my Twitter account @joeraptor. I will leave a link to it in the video description. And then I might highlight your picture at the end of a future Ghost of Tsushima video. Totally subscribe to stay up to date on all my future Ghost of Tsushima content. A like on the video would be super appreciated. Check my previous video on the Ghost Armor skins that I already like kind of touched on in this video. And other Ghost of Tsushima content is in the pinned comment, so you can easily find the one you are looking for. For now though, I will speak to you next time, and goodbye!